there's no scientific evidence out there that something like that can really happen. It would have to be a massive amount of fuel. Hey everybody, I'm meteorologist Cyrena Arnold, and I've done icing and turbulence test flights with NASA contractors, installed weather stations on the Alaska tundra, and was the director of the world-famous Mount Washington Observatory. Today, we're gonna be looking at storm scenes from TV and movies and figuring out how real they are.
Oh my God. Lisa, this tornado just came and erased the Hollywood sign.
Los Angeles isn't free of being hit by tornadoes. They absolutely can have them. In fact, since 1950, there have been 42 recorded tornadoes in Los Angeles. And in 1983, South LA took a direct hit from a rather large tornado and several people were killed. The chances of getting severe thunderstorms can happen anywhere. All 50 states of the United States have recorded tornadoes in them. We just happen to get a few more of them in the Midwestern United States because the ingredients for them to happen just are there a little bit more frequently.
What can you see? Is anyone hurt?
I wouldn't be surprised. There is so much damage.
Obviously, if you're going to be part of a media crew, you're going to want to capture a little bit of what's going on. You see the news helicopters flying right by the tornado, which they do from time to time. They'll follow tornadoes in news helicopters, but they're not going to be very close to it. And they're zooming in, I think, a little bit too.
Wait, it looks like they joined and formed one large tornado.
Two tornadoes merging into one. And we do see some instances out storm chasing where you could have a multiple vortice tornado. And that means that you actually have smaller little tornadoes that make up a larger one. And if the condensation in there, meaning the moisture and the water drops that you see, are visible only in those vortices and not surrounding the whole tornado itself, it can actually make it look like there's more than one tornado in one specific location. One thing that movies always kind of get funny is the background clouds and the surrounding storm around the tornado. How dark the sky is when there's a tornado occurring actually depends a lot on your position with the storm. If you're going to be on, say, the northeast side of the tornado and you're going to be under the main part of the thunderstorm, it's probably going to be really dark where you are. But there are places where you can actually have blue sky above you while watching a tornado. Tornadoes typically occur on the southwest side of thunderstorms, and if you happen to be in that area and say southeast of that southwest corner of the storm, you could have beautiful weather above you and see the sun shining on a tornado, making the storm and the tornado look white and not dark at all.
It's unbelievable, it's huge! I've never seen anything.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what the meter was. I'm guessing it was more like a seismograph type thing measuring the vibrations of the earth, but that definitely wasn't an anemometer measuring the wind speeds. I'd have to rate this one probably like a 6 or a 7. I don't think a tornado would be strong enough to pull creatures up out of the ocean. There is an instance in Louisiana in 1947 where it did rain down fish on a small town because it was likely picked up by a tornado. It's not going to end well for them. They're going to be pulled up to higher elevations. They could potentially freeze. Which isn't going to feel well, and then they're going to be falling back down to earth again and hitting the ground. But you're talking things that are pretty small and pretty light. So as the remnants of Hurricane Ida actually passed over New York and New Jersey just earlier this year, there were some situations where there was a flood warning and a tornado warning happening at the same time. And a warning means that it's imminent, that it's actually happening right now, not that it's going to. If I had to rate this from 1 to 10, it's a solid 1.
Everybody underground now!
Don't get in a car if there's a tornado. It's a terrible idea. Don't take safety in your car, please. While we're storm chasing, we're usually out in our cars. If you are in a safe place and you're not too close and want to get out and take a look at it, you can. But you want to try to stay fairly far away from them, you know, half mile to a mile away. And you always want to try to be maybe, you know, on like the southeast side. That's usually, for most tornadoes, the way they move, the safest place to be. There was a really devastating situation with a large tornado where there were 4 storm chasers killed in their vehicle because the tornado changed direction very rapidly. It grew rapidly, its speed changed, it was very unpredictable, and it ended up killing 4 people who were very knowledgeable about the weather. If you're that close to it, you need to seek shelter. You should be going to a basement if you have one. If you don't, try the lowest elevation that you have in your home and try to make it an interior room as possible. So an interior bathroom, under the stairwell, any of those places are really good safe places in a storm. tornadoes at night are something that do happen a lot, and they're almost impossible to see. They're actually extremely dangerous. Sometimes the only way you can see where they are is because you're seeing flashes of lightning reflect off the side of the tornado, or you're getting power flashes that show you where it is. Seeing the lightning right on the edges of the tornado is a little more rare. There have been some images captured of lightning with tornadoes happening in close proximity, but for the most part, it doesn't. Usually that's happening in a different part of the storm than where the tornado is located. So a lot of people think that it's a pressure differential that causes windows to break and things like that in a storm or when there's a tornado, and it's actually not. There are some pressure differentials there, and sometimes people can feel their ears pop if they're in a house and a tornado passes over it, but usually when you see things break like that, it's because of debris and high wind speeds. Tornadoes can pick up debris and move it and throw it beyond the distance of where that tornado was. So you can have cars that end up in trees or in homes. The static interference that you see on the TV, I think, is something that was a lot more popular before everything became digital. Back then, you know, you could see some static or some disruption in the signal as you have a big thunderstorm approaching. It may not necessarily mean that a tornado is there, but you could definitely get some disruption of the signals with a large, severe thunderstorm. So tornadoes are pretty mysterious in that they're a very small area of very, very high wind speeds. And weaker tornadoes or smaller ones have wind speeds around that 100 mile an hour or greater threshold, but your very large EF4, EF5 tornadoes can have wind speeds up to 300 miles an hour. And that's really, really devastating. Because you have such high wind speeds in a small area, they can rather pick or choose what they choose to destroy. I've seen homes that are perfectly still and untouched with just a roof ripped off. So for it to be able to pull off just pieces of this building that they're in and take those but leave other parts of the building just fine isn't uncommon. If I had to rate this clip on accuracy, it's pretty good. I'd give it like a 7. That's a lot of tornadoes very close together. I'd be running too if I saw that. The only way you can have multiple tornadoes by each other like that is sometimes when you see a tornado on the ground, it can have a satellite tornado, meaning a smaller one that's actually a part of the same storm that is rotating around it. But that small one is going to be tiny. It's going to look more like a waterspout type of a tornado going around there. But they're really rare. I've never seen one, and few meteorologists have. Otherwise, if you're lucky enough to see multiple storms lined up producing tornadoes at the same time, you might be able to see one from another, but that's really a stretch. To see them this close together and see that many happening at one time is just completely not possible at all. The best storm chase I've ever been on was October 9th of 2001 in Cordell, Oklahoma. We were out chasing and we saw 7 different tornadoes that day, which was phenomenal. It was a really great chase and we're really fortunate enough to see 7 different tornadoes, including one that was an F3. Tornadoes are rated by the Fujita scale, and now it's actually the enhanced Fujita scale because it was updated. EF5 is the maximum that you can reach on the EF scale. Tornadoes can absolutely hit large metropolitan areas like you see in this clip here. A lot of your tornadoes are a couple football fields wide, if that, but there are some big record-breaking ones out there. We've seen tornadoes up to a mile wide, and there's even been a tornado that's 2.6 miles wide across that was reported in El Reno, Oklahoma. A cold front can't be severe enough to take an airplane out of the sky like that, or freeze the ocean in the way that you saw here. There was an instance around Nantucket, actually, in January of 2018, where temperatures got cold enough where you actually could see some slush on the top of the ocean. So if it is cold enough, you can get some ice that forms there, but for it to freeze over instantaneously like that, it's just not gonna happen. Cold fronts do move quickly. They are something that we can see progress across the country at various speeds, and sometimes they can go 50, 60 miles an hour across, but they just don't have that drastic temperature change with them. I have seen some cold fronts come across Oklahoma where the backside of the cold front, it was in the teens, and on the front side, it was just close to 70 degrees. That's a really substantial and record-breaking cold front. But to see things, you know, happen like you saw here in this clip where people are freezing or water's freezing instantly, it's just not possible for that to happen. To be that extreme just isn't possible. It'd have to get like a 2 from me. Cold fronts are real and they do exist. They're not this extreme. And there was a tornado, but it was just a few too many of them. The way this tornado does the damage to this farm and to that building is actually pretty accurate. Having a tornado that far away actually pull someone up into it isn't realistic. Very few people have ever been able to say they've seen the inside of a tornado. I don't know of anybody personally who's been pulled up into a tornado inside their car and has lived to tell about it. There have been a lot of people who have taken some glancing blows from tornadoes or have been spun around on the ground in their car while the tornado passes over, but no instances of someone being pulled up in their car into the tornado and then coming out the top of the storm. There's no scientific evidence out there that something like that can really happen. It would have to be a massive amount of fuel. You do see tornadoes that are made up of fire, though. Actually, a lot of times when there are forest fires, you get things called fire whirls, which are like a dust devil, and they can encompass flames and actually be caused by the fire itself. So that's the closest thing I can think of to what you saw here. They looked a little bit more realistic than when you see in some other movies, but coming out up the top of the tornado and stuff like that is a little bit of a stretch. I'd give it like a 5. Was he hanging on by his tongue?
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay. You can take your weight in pounds. Cut that in half, and that'll be the speed in miles per hour that you'll be able to walk around max without getting blown over. So if you weigh 150 pounds, it's gonna be about 75 mile an hour winds are gonna be the max that you're gonna stay standing for. They're showing people being pulled up and sucked up. So typically, if you think about, say, a skydiver falling out of an airplane and they're free falling, they reach what's called terminal velocity. And that's around 120 to 125 miles an hour. So in order to pick somebody up again and do that and be taking them, the wind speeds would have to be at least 120 to 125 miles an hour. And how quickly they'd be moving past that would have to be added on to that amount. So if you want to see someone fly away from you at 25 miles an hour, you're going to need about 150 mile an hour winds to do so. Lightning is really dangerous. You know, it can actually occur 30 miles outside of a storm. So where you have your storm happening, lightning can go beyond it. So that's why there's a lot of these rules like the 30-30 safety rule. So after you see the last flash of lightning, wait 30 seconds until you hear that thunder. So then you know that that's at least 6 miles away. Then wait another 30 minutes before you go outside. And this is really critical for weather safety to make sure you don't get hit by lightning, because thousands of people are hit by lightning every year. I mean, it's gotta be a one. I don't know anyone who's got the power of weather. And I also don't know anyone who can hold on in 120 mile an hour winds with their tongue.
Right, to the right. I'm gonna get the trenches to the radio, see if I can get the Weather Channel. What does that thing mean?
There were a lot of cues in that to go somewhere safe and not just be messing around on the staircase. There were sirens going off. There was the loss of power. There was the tornado warning on the television, all things that people need to pay attention to. And those are all serious. You need to go take shelter when those things are happening. So the sirens you hear in the background are common in areas that are tornado prone. So if there's areas that are likely to get tornadoes in the Midwest, a lot of towns have tornado sirens. Now the average for the National Weather Service is somewhere between 8 and 11 minutes of warning before the tornado occurs, letting you know that it's on its way. The way they showed the inside of the house moving, you know, you could see some vibrations and things like that happening during a tornado. If it's passing by, it could last for a fairly long period of time like they showed here. I'd give it about a 7. I don't see too much wrong with it. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, why not check out the one right above?